Welcome back to this three-part video mini-series on X-ray and MRI. In video one, we looked at how X-ray and MRI work, and specifically we said that an MRI is a big magnet that spins hydrogen ions to create an image. And X-ray beams get blocked by denser tissues like bone, and that creates an image with shadows. Magnetic energy isn't harmful to your body, as far as we know. X-ray imaging, however, uses much higher frequency energy, and the radiation emitted is ionizing, which can cause cell damage if your yearly doses aren't within safe limits, which is extremely rare. In today's video, we're going to look at which imaging modality is best for posture assessment and structural alignment of your spine. A very uncomplicated description is that MRI is best for tissue and fluids, and X-ray is better for visualizing bone. MRI is good for soft bits, X-ray for hard bits. So which imaging modality is the best fit for each condition? For injury or trauma, which usually involves blood and inflammation, fluids, MRI. For multiple sclerosis, that disease is a neurological disease and deals with nerves and myelin, the sheath that covers those nerves. Again, soft bits, MRI. Leg pain. In this case, we're talking sciatica, the type of pain that comes from the buttocks, runs down the back of your leg right to your foot, and is usually the result of a herniated or slipped disc. Soft bits, nerve, MRI. For sudden bowel or bladder changes, loss of control, this is usually related to a herniated disc affecting the nerves that run the bowel and bladder. Again, nerves, soft bits, MRI. Acute or sudden low back pain, we're talking severe, 8, 9, 10 out of 10 for pain. This is usually associated with a slipped disc irritating the nerve. Again, soft bits, MRI. Now, what about chronic low back pain? Chronic low back pain usually indicates some degenerative changes in the body and often the discs. So in this case, the pain usually rates maybe a 3, 4, 5 out of 10, not usually acute. And so then we'd like to see the structure, the alignment in the spine. So we're going to be looking at the bony vertebra. Bones, X-ray. If you have forward head posture, the head is sitting ahead of your shoulders, usually that means the curve in your neck has been altered. And it's the vertebra, the bony vertebra that make up the curve. So we want an X-ray. What about neck hump? Well, this is interesting. A neck hump itself is usually the soft, squidgy fat that you feel at the base of the neck. But the reason for the neck hump may be structural. In other words, the curve in the neck has flattened or reversed. And again, curves are created by the alignment of the vertebra, the bony vertebra. So X-ray. Scoliosis is a structural curvature in the spine. And again, we want to track and measure the bony alignment of the vertebra. So X-ray. If you have flat back posture, the curve in your lower back is decreased and looks relatively flat. Again, this usually means there's been degeneration and wear in the discs. So we want to look at the curve. The vertebra, the bony vertebra, makes up the curve. So we want an X-ray. I hope that gives you a better idea of which modality you need. It's pretty clear that if you need your posture and spinal alignment assessed, X-ray is the gold standard. Remember to check with your doctor or chiropractor if you're not sure. Make sure you're subscribed so you receive the third and final video in this three-part mini-series, where we'll look at some real examples of spinal X-rays and posture conditions.